architecture you're seeing is data. My data. When I'm plugged into the chair, this is what I see.
You're
using an earlier version of that technology. A brainwave scanner instead of a direct neural wire. Look around. Do you see that yellow column in the distance? That's long-term memory storage. That's your goal. But you can't just retrieve that data yourself. One of the programs loaded in that holotape is called the Indexer. They're represented by the friendly green sprites milling around. Do you see them?
Didn't actually mean to leave that. Whoops. That was a lot to take in at once, though. Holy hell. I was confused. Interesting they used the workshop for that.
The indexers have one purpose, to get the data in the yellow column and bring it back to the memory access point. You need to help them get there and back safely. Once they've recovered all the data in the memory, the program will translate it into something you can understand. If you ever need to leave the simulation, then don't worry. Nothing gets reset. You can keep going from wherever you left off. Good. You are across the gap. But now you have to deal with the security systems. That red firewall is blocking you and your indexers from reaching the data. Do you see that green beam of light? That's a decoder beam. It can destroy the firewall. You just need to direct the beam to its vulnerable spot. Good. You are across the gap. But now you have to deal with the security systems. That red firewall is blocking you and your indexers from reaching the data. Do you see that green beam of light? That's a decoder beam. It can destroy the firewall. You just need to direct the beam to its vulnerable spot. Good. Now you just need to create a path to the data with code blocks, and your indexers can get to work.
It's like lemmings.
Now things will get hairier. You'll need to deploy defense constructs against the system's active countermeasures. The system's sentries will do everything they can to stop your indexers from returning to the access point with the data. Thank you.
intrusive program detected.
One more data block recovered.
Unauthorized indexer erased.
This is a lot like a Shadowrun.
Detected. Countermeasures initiated.
Verifying memory file. 100%. We're done here. We now have an access point into the next memory. Just step into the data stream where this memory was stored.
Memory file identification 0V-9AX0. Converted to audio transcription. Beginning playback.
Things are not going well with Far Harbor. Several of my people have been assaulted, spat at, interrogated for no reason. This is getting out of control. But there's still a chance they can learn to trust us. We just need one of their own who's on our side. I can't let anyone know what I'm about to do. I'll need to set up the equipment far away from Acadia. Double as a place to bury the evidence.
Additional location data appended. A makeshift medical facility underneath the Vim. Pop factory. Coordinates downloaded.
Interesting. Was he turning people into synths? Is this the reason why? Interesting.
Thank you.
Data breach detected. Initiating anti-intrusion countermeasures. Intrusive indexer eliminated. Sentry has detected active intrusive program. Beginning attrition of intrusive program.
I can build them like a little trench here.
Intrusive program detected. Beginning attrition of intrusive program. Intrusive program detected. Beginning attrition of intrusive program. Sentry has detected active intrusive program. Sentry has detected active intrusive program. Beginning attrition of intrusive program. Intrusive program detected. Beginning attrition of intrusive program. Beginning attrition of intrusive program.
The AI is a little buggy. That was a double pun, by the way.
Intrusive program detected.
Another data block retrieved. One more to go.
Sentry has detected active intrusive program.
Memory retrieval at 100%. Verifying. Looks good. You can now use the data stream as an access point to the next memory.
Memory file identification 0J-2NN8. Converted to audio transcription. Beginning playback.
I'm offloading this memory. I cannot bear lying to Confessor Martin and his Children of Adam any longer. better to just forget. I found it. The location of the launch key to fire the nuclear missile inside the submarine. Confessor Martin believes it can bring his people into division. Destruction at the hands of an atomic blast. He struggles with how literal his interpretation of that precept should be. I can't risk him deciding to find the key and use it. His people were the first to accept me for what I am. The thought of them being gone fills me with nothing but pain.
Additional data appended. Location: the Harbor Grand Hotel safe room. Key code 485130.
Intrusive program detected. Warning. Data breach detected. Intrusion countermeasures initiated. Sentry beginning erasure protocol against unauthorized indexer. Intrusive program detected.
Complete memory retrieved. The data stream is now available to access the next memory.
Memory file identification 0H-3X0P. Converted to audio transcription. Playback.
I've made a contingency plan in case Far Harbor discovers the truth or gives in to their xenophobia despite all my efforts. I've isolated the wind turbine powering Far Harbor's fog condensers. A kill switch command will leave them defenseless from the fog and its creatures. But now that it's done, am I really capable of this? This massacre that I've engineered? I'm going to remove the command code from my memories. I'll bury a hard copy if I need to use it. But I can't keep it close to me. It makes me sick.
Additional location data appended. Coordinates to the kill switch command code and the wind farm maintenance building.
How did I even get it over there? Jump didn't work. Puzzles, I love them. Kind of. A love-hate relationship. I can totally see somebody making a mod with this. Yeah, I can't do this without something.
Adam guards our souls from darkness.
Hey.
Go on. All you gotta do is ask.
Your thoughts?
You're one hell of a partner.
That's all for now.
Well, all right.
Thank you. Is there any way to make this a shortcut?
Divide comes.
mind if I do. This was a hospital. It's a freaking factory.
Something.
What are your friends?
cars are going bonkers, beeping like crazy. AKA 35% more damage.
Someone's coming.
Oh.
Thank you.
Heads up.
Do something.
There's a behemoth behind that door. I don't know if I'm ready for it. Oh, that looks like a smiley face, this guy right here.
sir. Must have been nothing. I hear something.
Damn straight you did.
There we go.
Noise. That'll be a good fight.
What's that?
Bowling. Oh, crap.
My leg!
dude. Man, this is one finicky lock.
Got it.
This is like Coca-Cola and Pepsi or something. Because Coca-Cola is winning over Pepsi by far.
People like more Sprite more than Sierra
Mist. People like Coca-Cola more than
Pepsi, etc., etc. Only thing I got is Mountain Dew. I gotta admit, I like Coca-Cola more than Pepsi.
Going to be like having everything you are ripped out and replaced with something else. Someone else.
I'm ready. I wish I could say goodbye to everyone.
No one else can know. This isn't just about infiltrating Far Harbor. It's about becoming the human that synths drawn here need to meet. Reasonable. Willing to accept them as just another living thing. Please approach the intercom. Or lesser than humanity itself. You'll be part of the bridge between our two worlds. That all vanishes the moment anyone discovers that it's been manufactured. That you're a synth.
Did she have to die? The woman I'm replacing? God, she looks so peaceful lying there.
Don't. Please. That blood is on my hands, not yours.
Scanning. Approved user detected. Synth prototype. Unlocking medical area door.
How? Just who are you?
I am Kai 1.1, a computer intelligence designed to control medical facilities, specifically the room through that door. You match all specifications for an approved user. Personally speaking, they were very narrow.
This must be Dima's handiwork. Guess he never thought another prototype synth would be on the island. Might as well grab anything useful we find in there. antiques, huh?
Franny, it's me. I'm at the Grand. In our old suite. 485130. That's the key to the safe room they installed in case of... the bombs. Franny, I need you to come quick. I don't know when they'll be coming for me, so... I prepped the boat in case we need to make a rapid exit. But I can't be a part of this. Nuclear war? I won't do it. And I'm not gonna let anyone else use my submarine to blow up the damn world. Please, Franny. I need you here. If this is the end, let's spend it together.
Thank you.
Hi. He threw the phone at me and it hung up. Yeah. Huh? I'm sorry. Sorry, I can't hear you. Connor. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Say it again, I'm sorry. No. Not really. Still child at heart. Doesn't mean Chuck E. Cheese, but you know what I mean. Yeah, that's probably doable. Yeah, but I want your loot, so we got a problem. That's creepy as hell. uncover the mystery of the Hunter's Heart.
Chill in my bones. It won't come out. Too many nights I've slept.
stranger. You need odds, ends, junk, or knickknacks. You've come to the right place.
Let's trade.
Let's see.
Thank you.
shadow you. She saw you entering and leaving the nucleus. So, what was in my memory banks? Are we closer to resolving the conflict on this island peacefully?
Your memories led me to a gravesite. You killed Captain Avery and replaced her with a synth. So you could control Far Harbor.
What? That's impossible. Let me see what you found. I did it. I killed a woman from Far Harbor and replaced her. I stripped a synth's identity from her and made her an agent.
Why did you do it?
I needed to calm Far Harbor. A moderate voice. An example of what humanity should be. How we could exist together as equals. But I couldn't live with the memories of the blood on my hands. A human and a synth are both gone because of me.
You did the right thing. For the future of your people.
Yes. Yes. No one leaves this world clean. Sacrifices have to be made.
Sacrifices? You're talking about cold-blooded murder.
I'm starting to see things more clearly. We have to keep this secret from Far Harbor. They wouldn't destroy just me. They'd come after Acadia, and then without us, the fog condensers will eventually fall into disrepair. Everyone will die. I have an idea. There's still a way we can bring peace. But the fact that I've replaced a human with a synth must remain hidden.
So, you did all of that on your own? No one else in Acadia is involved?
What I've done goes against all of our ideals. Even hid it from myself. So, no, there can't be anyone else.
I'll keep your secret, Dima.
Thank you. Maybe the guilt will keep me focused.
It didn't seem to stop it before.
As horrifying as it might be to suggest, this memory you've recovered has given us a new option. If Far Harbor could be made more tranquil by our intervention, then perhaps the same trick will work twice on the children of Atom. We could replace High Confessor Tectus with someone willing to forgive Far Harbor and work towards reconciling it.
There must be another way we can make things right.
None that I can see. The authority of the High Confessor is absolute. The children of Atom won't see the need for peace unless he changes his mind.
All right. Tell me what your plan is.
This will be difficult for both of us, but I think it's our only option. I'll need you to leverage your access to the High Confessor and lure him to a secluded location. You should be able to find a spot in the Bay's old command center where you can deal with him discreetly and hide the remains. Once your work is done, return here and the replacement will move in and take command.
You really think you can get together a convincing replacement?
Yes. Helping synths recover what they've lost means we've had to become familiar with memory wipes and facial reconstruction. And I knew Tectus very well when I was still living in the submarine base. I'll use that as the basis for our replacement's new memories. You simply need to deal with the real Confessor Tectus while I prepare a volunteer.
Do we have to kill the High Confessor?
It would be the most reliable way of dealing with him. but any method that removes Tectus from power indefinitely should work.
Are the children going to stand down just because this replacement tells them to?
Dissent may arise, but the children have seen what happens to those who speak out. Our replacement will leverage that fear to serve the greater good.
Okay, I'll do it. Any ideas on how I can get him alone?
Tectus lives in fear of being usurped by his predecessor, Martin. Despite that, in all likelihood, Martin is dead. But if you somehow uncovered evidence of Martin's imminent return, I expect Tectus would be interested in hearing all you know in private. All we have to do is manufacture Martin's uprising. To do so, I'll need raw material. Martin recorded many of our conversations. Those in the nucleus have certainly been destroyed. But I built a small refuge for Martin many years ago when he needed respite from the family. Go there and collect any tapes you can find. I'll begin work on our replacement. And here, I want you to have this as well, for what you've done for us.
Fog's bad during the day.
We need fog. There's things out there.
Don't talk to Bertha. She's crazy.
The Lees sell guns. Over by the torch. The owner says...
Children of Adam are dangerous.
Don't let the island catch you off guard.
Why my guns?
Fresh shipment. All your medical and food needs.
You been to the tannery? You find my tools yet?
Thank you.
first, Maxwell hasn't seen the state of the hotel. He would be devastated. I should warn you, some of the other hotel guests are a bit, rowdy. I was forced to defend myself when a few became a bit handsy, shall we say. The registered patrons are in a more exclusive area of the hotel, though, and do not associate with this sort of rabble. Shall we be off?
What do you mean, the other patrons are rowdy?
I had not been in this part of the hotel for some time. Perhaps there is some sort of sporting event that has them agitated. Several of them tried to grab me and, well, shall we be off?
Yeah, let's go.
Very good.
Hello. Are you hiding? Armed over here.
Drat, the elevators seem to be out of order on this level. We'll have to take the long way around.
Thank you.
doesn't sound pleased. Say we get out of here.
Thank you.
The detective's life isn't an easy one.
Speak to Maxwell. Go ahead and activate the control panel there.
Greetings. Welcome to Vault 118, your home away from home, underground. Are you the detective we sent for?
It's me, Pearl. I've returned with the investigator.
Let me just get the door for you.
This place is closed off. One of them is the murderer.
Dreadful to think it, but I suppose logically you must be correct. And the crime scene again?
Sounds like trouble.
Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me, Detective.
I shall return to my workstation and allow you to take things from here.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Excuse me.
Yes, you have
their entire lives.
Our friend is dead, Mr. Avita. Have you no respect?
You to say that at least he had the decency to make a spectacle of it. There is nothing worse than
if I may.
That's what
this is to you. I could just have your attention.
You're sick.
I'm sorry for shouting. But the detective has arrived and shall begin the investigation henceforth. Please return to your rooms until the detective has examined the crime scene and had a chance to come speak with you. Have a look at the crime scene for clues. Already, discuss your findings. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have solid evidence, I would avoid accusations.
Is this blood?
Heads up.
Need something?
Your thoughts?
Not at this rate. We're gonna have to put your name up on signs for the agency.
Your thoughts?
Got myself real lucky you pulled me out of the...
That's all for now.
All right.
Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed.
Protect and serve. Protect and serve.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis. Was there anything else?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, then I suppose you'll need to confront the killer. Was there anything else?
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel. He had vast experience managing venture projects around the world. It was his idea to have our premises in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here, should you need me.
Why'd you do it? He deserved better than that.
You think I'm stupid? I saw the way he looked at you. You gonna tell me that's nothing?
It wasn't like that. We were friends. He helped me out of a tight spot or two is all.
I couldn't stand by like some pasty-faced Percy while he put the moves on my best girl.
But now the law is on our tail. What are we going to do?
Come away with me. Let's leave this dark hole of a city behind. We can be in Buenos Aires by tomorrow.
Oh, I want to believe you, I do, but never let us go.
Then we'll make our stand here. I've got a gun for each of us.
No, 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 no. The line is, then we'll make our stand here. Two lovers together with a bullet for each of them.
God, why can't I ever get that line? Forget it. I can't do this right now.
Fine. I'm going to the beach. Well now, if it isn't the brave detective. I haven't seen someone with a body like that in far, far too long.
You're not so bad.
That was the envy of every girl in Lex for days, darling. I'm sure you'd rather hear some of my stories from the silver screen rather than talk about that nasty murder business.
I must say, you're quite the actress.
What can I say? It just comes naturally. Surely you must be here for my salacious stories of the silver screen.
Have you ever done radio? Your voice is quite enchanting.
Well, darling, play your cards right, and maybe I'll whisper some sweet nothings in your ear. Kiss me. Care to hear some of my stories, Detective?
I must say, I've known flesh and blood girls who aren't half the woman you are.
Keep it up, Tiger, and we'll find out if you can handle how much woman I am. Surely you must be here for my salacious stories of the Silver Screen.
Why don't we grab a bottle of wine and go watch the sunset?
Sounds good, Detective.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Is there a question?
That was great, Detective. But we probably shouldn't make a habit of this. Catch you later, Tiger. Hey there, Tiger. Here for more stories about my acting career, or something else?
All right.
I used to do musicals back when they were in fashion. The Beautiful Cigar Girl, Wagons on the Plain, A Woman of the Royal Navy. They were ever so much fun. Did you need something else?
What were you and Keith talking about when I came in?
Oh, that? We were rehearsing! Gotta stay sharp if we're going to rebuild Hollywood. But Keith always gets flustered when he's upset. Did you need something else?
Maybe later.
I'll be around. Hey there, Tiger. Here for more stories about...
Sure.
He'll deny ever saying it, but Keith once told me he caught Vince Natale and Sergio Amore together. Did you need something else?
Tell me about yourself.
My favorite subject. Simply put, when this international scuffle blows over, I shall return to the Silver... Did you need something else?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Well, it is a bit strange how obsessed Santiago has been with the murder. I mean, he's always been a bit obsessive, though. He did a whole series of paintings of me, hundreds! Said I was his muse. It was flattering for a while, but the man is a bit much, even for me. Did you need something else?
Never mind.
I'll be around, languishing from your inattention.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
It's obviously Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
What were you and Gilda talking about when I walked in?
Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
Tell me about yourself.
Well, as you probably know, I'm an actor. I don't like to brag about it, but my last picture, The Fighting Furies, it topped the box office.
Never mind.
Okay, just let me know.
Nice.
serve. Protect and serve.
Baseball bat. What is this doing here? Red paint?
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
Oh no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here.
Right.
Protect and serve.
How absolutely inspiring.
Well.
Art is life. Without it, we are no different than animals.
Perhaps, if all we are is a sentience floating in a suit of flesh, or metal, I suppose, then art is the only true communion with the world. Come with me. Tell me, what does this
It's about composition, the balance of colors and emotions, and the struggle to maintain internal order.
Indeed. This was the last piece I did in a series of portraits of Gilda. Number 1378. Her emotional landscape is superimposed on the portrait. The reality of the subject is distorted as the ego attempts to project itself. This way. Tell me, what does this one say to you?
It's the war. Bombs from every direction, no up or down, the world turned on its head.
I suppose in a way it must be. Art shapes the world, and the world shapes art in return. All art must therefore be constantly reborn through the lens of contextual and historic interpretation. We must ascend. Be honest, for art without honesty is just politics.
It's cute, I guess. Some people like that kind of thing.
More than you would imagine. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course. This series has meant more money than any of my serious works. And I did the whole thing as a lark. What does that tell you about the value of art to the common man, huh? My fellow connoisseur of the art. Here to see my latest work.
I found red paint at the crime scene. You know anything about that?
No, actually. Ezra borrowed my last gun. Now I can't find it.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Reeves. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and Ezra had a rather dramatic fight recently. You could hear her banshee screeches all the way across the hotel.
What were Juliana and Ezra arguing about?
I don't know. I was painting at the time and I was trying to block it out. Though I bet Gildo probably heard them. Maybe you should check with her.
Never mind. Juliana and Ezra had an argument a few days before he was found dead. Tell me about that.
Well, I was in my lab at the time, so I didn't hear it. But Juliana has always been rather critical of Mr. Parker. I think she found something in the overseer's office. I wasn't listening when she told me about it. I kind of had my head in my research. I don't know, really. I try to let her handle all the money stuff. Was there something else, Detective?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Oh, well, that's not really my field of expertise, but I'm sure there are probably some clues at the crime scene. Was there something else, Detective?
Tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm a scientist. You've probably met my wife, Juliana, already. Not sure what else to say, really. Was there something else, Detective?
Tell me about your research.
Well, I was one of the leads on the team that created the first robo-brains, the precursors to our model. Most people don't find it all that interesting, and I'd rather not bore you. Was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
Oh, wonderful. No one else here really wants to talk about it. Functionally, this model is more or less the same as the previous versions I worked on, but without the neural inhibitor and the reconditioning. The voice modulator seems to have some minor issues interfacing with the neural matrix, which can add some moodiness. But that's easily solved with regular tune-ups. Was there something else, Detective?
I'd like
it. I'm afraid that's really all I... Was there something...
robo-brains have a voice.
That's what allows us to recreate our... I've speculated for some time that the issues we had with our... maintaining our original voices helps reinforce the neural network, sort of like playing music for an Alzheimer patient. Was there something else, Detective?
Maybe.
Very well, and...
Hello, Detective. Did you have a question about the heinous murder?
I heard...
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay... I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out at
him. Uh-huh. What's with all the...
These are our things. We're just waiting to...
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Juliana Riggs, heiress to the Riggs fortune and wife of Bert Riggs. I'm not sure what else you expected, Detective.
Did you have any...
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
Never mind.
Good luck.
Did you need something? Forgot a personal item at home.
Did you have any thoughts on the case?
I'm afraid not, Detective.
Mm-hmm.
Need to restock on Hunt. Let me know if you...